Well, hey, race fans, I'm Joe Koss, and although the half mile at Stafford Motor Speedway may be quiet for the time being, there's plenty of activity getting ready for the 2016 racing season ahead at race shops throughout the state of Connecticut and beyond. Today, a new series that myself and Darren Ayotte will host throughout the winter months. Today, we go to Keith Rocco's shop to see what's cooking in the 88 camp. Keith Rocco here. Thank you for having us in your shop here. And Keith, you've got a very impressive facility. You're a very busy man throughout the summer months, but what you have here is an impressive race shop.
Thank you. You know, this layout's 40 by 60, and I thought it was going to be big enough in the beginning, but it just it's never big enough, as they always say.
So how many modifieds do you have housed here that you maintain every week?
On the average, it's 5 cars that I house and maintain and try to keep up with. You know, we don't run 5 every week, but we'll probably run 3 a week.
So of course now the off season, the racetrack is quiet, but at the shop it's pretty busy. And each of the modifieds that you have here, Keith, you don't have any engines in. So what's part of the process of you in the off season to get ready for a full slate of racing?
Well, usually the first thing is, you know, we pull the motors out, send them out to get freshened up, pull the trannies out, send them up to get freshened up. You know, these cars are all pretty straight. You know, I got a pretty good mindset. I know, you know, what I hit, what I bounced off of. Yeah. So, you know, the chassis are good. We start with the basics. You know, we just packed all the wheel bearings in this car, put all new rotors on it, and go through the rear ends, just pop them apart, look at them, make sure the gears look good, and, you know, put things back together, clean them up, and start fresh.
Now, the season ends in early October, and then it's April by the time we're back on the racetrack again. How much time in the off season are you working on these race cars?
Usually, you know, when the race season ends, you're pretty burnt out, you know, racing 100 races a year, 90 to 100 races a year. It gets pretty tough. So usually when race season ends, you know, I'll take a month off, and, you know, I'll come out here 1 or 2 nights a week and putz around, you know, start pulling motors. But, you know, come January, it's really crunch time. We got to get going and get prepared for the new season.
Take us through the shop a little bit, because if you look around this place, there's trophies, and this one's pretty cool here. The trophy for the 4th Annual Lincoln Tech Institute, the Valente Modified Racing Series 80 at Stafford a few years ago. Take us through that special piece.
That's probably one of the coolest things I've received out of all the races I won. You know, trophies are a dime a dozen. You know, luckily I win a lot, so they're a dime a dozen, but was able to wrangle that away from my car owner, John Rufrano. It sat in a trailer for a little while, and I think we all kind of forgot about it, so when nobody was looking, I snuck it out. And this is prior to building this race shop, so I knew we were in the process of getting things rolling. So once it was up, I couldn't wait to hang that thing up. It was probably one of the first pieces of memorabilia I hung up in here.
On this side of the garage, you've got a whole trophy wall with all the different successes that you've had in the past. You look back at that first victory for you, at the time you were driving for what Gene Guy Poulin in that white and red number 78, and your trophy that you earned that day from 2005 is still sitting here. Take us through your memories of that first win at Stafford.
You know, that was one I'll never forget. It definitely separates itself from the rest, not only because it was my first win, but it was a rain-delayed race, and I think I was running, you know, somewhere in the top 5 that day. And we were always really good during the day, and we just never really nailed a night setup down. And for some reason, they postponed that race to July 4th. It was a Sunday. And we had an awesome day set up, and we went there, and it was just like everything fell into place. You know, we ended up winning the race, and first one. It was an awesome day.
I have to be honest, though, with you. That one makes me a little bit bitter, because at the time I was a crew member for another competitor in the SK Modified division. We had the reverse fortune. We were leading under the night, and then in the daytime, all of a sudden your car came to life. So I remember that win pretty vividly back in 2005.
Yeah, well, I guess you're on the wrong team that day.
So Keith, with all these modifieds in your garage, you've got a lot of work to do to keep these cars prepared. How many rear ends are you going to prepare for this season moving ahead?
I usually take them all apart and just, usually they don't need nothing. But it's always good just to look in them and make sure all the gears are not pitted up and not getting chewed up, you know. During race season, it's not something you normally take apart unless it gets bent, so you usually don't have a chance to look at it. I mean, as you can see by looking at this one, it's pretty perfect, so we'll just clean it up, put some new seals in it, re-silicone it, and put it right back in.
What type of stuff are you looking for when you're looking at this gear?
You know, when they get chewed up, they'll start to pit in here, and just same thing on the pinion. They'll just they'll get pits and kind of just flake apart a little bit. So you just, you know, take them apart, spin them, look at them, make sure everything looks good, make sure all the bearings spin nice, and go from there.
We certainly thank Keith for his time and welcoming us into his shop to give us a little bit of time and a tour behind the scenes. Stay tuned for more on staffordspeedway.com as we take you behind the scenes in the preparation heading into the 2016 racing season.